Hi, I'm Courtney.
I'm Brielle.
I'm Stacy.
I'm Kirk.
I'm Kira.
And I'm Brittany.
And this is our retreat.
The guy in the middle is Kirk Muller. He spent 16 years playing in the National Hockey League. He won a Stanley Cup with the Montreal Canadiens. Now, he coaches the Carolina Hurricanes. All winter long, he's in charge of a large group of men. During the summer, different story.
There's a lot of girls running around. I said I live a Jekyll and Hyde life. I go to the rink and I got all this power. I got all these guys and I come here, I have absolutely no powers.
Hockey season runs from August to June, so Kirk has 7 weeks to spend with his family at their lakeside cottage, just outside Kingston, Ontario. The 4,500 square foot, two-story lake house was built for one simple reason, family.
Salute and cheers.
Cheers.
We said that this is going to be a place that is our base, our home, and
summer.
Where we're going to spend our summers with our family.
We wanted to be close to all the grandparents and cousins and aunts and uncles. So we do a lot of gatherings here, and we enjoy that.
That's a lot of people, so there's a lot of room. The first thing you see is the great room, loaded with comfortable charm.
You get the feel by looking around of what we're looking to do. You know, that old
that
world.
Old world feeling, and we try to do that with some old barn beams and some antiques. My favorite are a lot of the lighting.
If you look at the fireplace, we have stone from a local quarry, and we had a local mason come in, and just this is a nice wood-burning stove.
The floorboards and the beams are also local. They're reclaimed wood from an old barn just a few kilometers away.
We've kept all the rustic look of, like, we didn't fill it in or anything because we just wanted to look natural and just fit right in.
The local flavor has been combined with international flair.
Traveled a lot in North America and over in Europe, and I think the fun part is that we took our time and we really kind of collectively came up with different ideas. There's some things in there that are gothic looking, old world, and
Italy and France were two favorite destinations. We loved going there. And so we definitely took a few ideas from those areas.
They took more than ideas. The backsplash in the kitchen is made of tile they brought home from a vacation on Italy's Amalfi Coast.
This kitchen works really well. We've got four daughters that are all wonderful helpers on the prep work as well as the cleanup. So I'm really, we're lucky that way. There's so much space that everybody can actually do a good job.
There's also space on the main floor for the master bedroom.
We just had this deck built. Beautiful view of the lake.
We got all our daughters and the friends coming out. This is a good opportunity to kind of sneak away sometimes, and we'll just have a glass of wine here and do the sunset. And they take over the boathouse, they take over the dock and all
take
that.
Take over so, a lot of the space.
So we're second fiddle at times, and so it's kind of a little quiet spot to sit back and enjoy it.
As a hockey guy living with five women, Kirk has tried hard to keep a couple manly things in the house.
This is our mudroom. If you look at it, you see four stalls for my four daughters, and it's kind of the old hockey theme. So we didn't put their name tags up, but they know which one's theirs. And so it's basically a girly-like way of making a locker room kind of.
The real hockey stuff has been relegated to the basement.
I did spend a little time in the hockey world, so as you can see in this room, this is sort of a little collection of, you know, my career playing in the NHL.
Including a photo from the night the Habs won the Stanley Cup.
As you can see from my face, it's one of the happiest moments of my time, and great friends with Mike Keane and Guy Carbonneau playing down in Montreal. If you look around, you know, my idol is Wayne Gretzky. Fortunate to get one of his jerseys signed. And in the corner, Mike Keane, who was one of the best teammates I ever had.
Two old chairs from the Montreal Forum and a half dozen framed photos is about all the room Kirk gets.
We had to give him some spot. There's a wine cellar, little bar.
Yeah.
If Dad has his own little spot, you know his four daughters need four very special places as well.
This is Kira's room. Actually, come on in.
I wanted my bedroom to be like a cloud. We were shopping for furniture and we came across this wallpaper and we fell in love with it.
And then we built the bedroom around the wallpaper, actually, didn't we?
Yeah. And then eventually, everything just slowly came into place.
This is Brittany's room.
Yeah. We just redid this room, actually, this summer, and I had a chance to paint it.
Yes.
Because I did it when I was 13, and it was a very bubblegum pink. So, and I think it comes together really nicely.
This is Brielle's room.
My parents took me to Paris for my 16th birthday, so I got that. So yeah, I designed the room after that, and so I got a little Paris statue over there. And I love Audrey Hepburn, so it's over top of my bed.
This is Courtney's room here.
When we picked the house, everyone ran to grab the best room, and I just kind of strolled down and ended up with the best one.
Kirk and Stacy's favorite room isn't really a room at all. It's a screened-in porch.
The great thing is we start every morning with a coffee. It's a nice way to go back and finish off the night as well, sitting back and having a glass of wine there. Start with a coffee and finish with a glass of wine.
That's pretty much it.
If you want wine, you need grapes. Luckily, there's some right nearby.
Kind of a new hobby that I never thought I'd ever get involved with, so, but I love it up here.
Kirk Muller has played and coached in the NHL for more than 20 years. To hockey fans across the country, he's known as Captain Kirk. But puttering around his cottage near Kingston, Ontario, he's a dad, a husband, and a struggling organic farmer.
We're good.
They've got 117 acres, but in one small corner, fruit trees are taking over.
I accidentally went into a barn this night to buy some eggs.
Just to buy eggs.
And we walked out buying over 100 fruit trees. Well, this is the so-called orchard. We use up about 5 acres, and we started off with, as you can see, a bunch of the organic fruit trees here. Collectively, after 4 or 5 years, we're just seeing the growth now, and next year is supposed to be the big year.
He's also got grapes, but he's a few years away from making his own wine.
They're not the wine growing. They're actually more like edible to eat. That'd be the next step. More experiment. This is why I put the farmer clothes on, and I find this is actually my most relaxing spot. Kind of a new hobby that I never thought I'd ever get involved with, so, but I love it up here.
Carolina Hurricane fans don't need to worry, though. He's not quite ready to give up hockey for a career in farming.
It's a hobby right now, but I really respect when you're looking at the climate and all the, Mother Nature that comes into effect of really, affects your trees and your crops and everything. You gotta have a lot of respect for farmers.
Kirk is the king of the orchard, and Stacy rules the roost in the main cottage. The boathouse? That's for Courtney, Brielle, Kira, and Brittany.
Here's our girls right here. So, what are you girls doing?
Playing a little crazy.
Playing crazy eights. Well, this is a big place for us to bring some friends and hang out, play some cards.
The boathouse is really a second cottage, complete with its own kitchen, bathroom, and sleeping quarters.
There's a lot of bunk beds up here, so we can put quite a few kids up there. This is it.
They think it's cool. It's kind of like a little bit of a camp. They have their own little private spot here, and so they feel like it's their little destinations.
Of course, there's more to life at the cottage than playing crazy eights.
We're water people. Really, you know, enjoying the summer, the sun, being down on the dock, being on the water, swimming. That takes up a lot of our, entertainment down there.
We've got the new paddle boards.
Paddle boards are a big new thing now, so it's we've kind of turned in the sea-doos to the paddle boards lately. So.
With so much going on, Kirk's seven-week break from the hockey world never seems long enough.
Well, we know that one day we'll be back here, you know, eventually longer and everything, but, you know, we're still loving the life that we're in the hockey world.
Where do you want to go next?
It's a busy pace where we are right now in North Carolina, and then when we come back and all the places we've ever lived, it's always been very busy, and here is relaxing.